We are getting a word out from the Biden campaign, putting out a statement in just the last couple of minutes. Eamon Javers joins us with the latest on that. Eamon.
Yeah, Melissa, this is a sharply worded statement from the Biden campaign responding now to the president who falsely declared victory earlier tonight. Now, Jen O'Malley Dillon, the Biden campaign manager, saying the president's statement tonight about trying to shut down the counting of duly cast ballots was outrageous, unprecedented, and incorrect. It was outrageous because it is a naked effort to take away the democratic rights of American citizens. And then they respond to the president's idea about going to the Supreme Court, saying if the president makes good on his threat to go to the court to try to prevent the proper tabulation of votes, we have the legal teams standing by and ready to deploy to resist that effort, and they will prevail. So a sharp response now from the Biden campaign to the president in the East Room earlier tonight. Also, we've got a tweet now from the Democratic chair of Wisconsin, Ben Wickler, who is saying that Democrats in Wisconsin, at least, are confident that Joe Biden can still win that state, will still win that state. The reason why, the Democratic chair says, is because absentee ballots are still being tallied in Milwaukee, Kenosha, and other cities. Based on everything we've seen, those ballots will decisively favor Biden. Green Bay hasn't reported any results yet. So that from Democrats in Wisconsin. Clearly, a lot of states still hanging in the balance, Melissa, and nobody has this thing set in stone just yet. Back over to you.
Eamon, with both sides sort of setting up for legal battles, is this considered or could this be considered a potential constitutional crisis? I mean, I asked you this because the eyes of the world are upon us. And just moments ago, the German defense minister, for what this is worth, told German TV that this is a situation they're very concerned about because they do see this as a constitutional crisis.
You know, Melissa, I don't think we're there yet. I mean, this is the counting of the ballots process that's going on right now. This is well within the legal bounds. What we saw from the president tonight was certainly unprecedented. And the president is clearly attempting to cast doubt on the legitimacy of this election if he loses. That said, ballot counting is going on in all of these states that haven't suspended for the night to get a couple of hours rest. If there are court challenges, we've seen that before, too, in this country, going back to Bush v. Gore, most notably, where we didn't have a decision for, I think it was about 36 days after Election Day. So all of that has played out before in this country. And as long as it's playing out in the courts and in the legal process appropriately, it's not a constitutional crisis. More.